Hi there, it's Carrie here, and I would like to talk to you a little bit about my recent blood patch I had performed at Cedars Sinai. It was a little bit different than my previous four blood patches. This one was considered a high volume blood patch. For those of you who are watching who you suspect you have a CSF leak, maybe you've been diagnosed with a CSF leak and you have not yet had a blood patch. Do yourself a favor and go visit the CSF Leak Foundation website if you're in the US. I think it's the CSF Leak Association website if you are in the UK. This is not considered the first line of treatment, I don't believe, if you've never had a blood patch done, or even if you've had probably one blood patch, you probably wouldn't just go right into a high volume. And when I say high volume, I mean I'm referring to the amount of blood that's actually injected into your subdural space. A regular blood patch you could have anywhere between, I believe, like 4 milliliters and like 30-ish milliliters. Anything after 35 up, I believe, is considered high volume. There's also ultra high volume blood patches, which are that's getting into the stratosphere and bizarro land. And I believe this particular procedure is relatively uncommon, but it's not rare, I don't think. My procedure was performed at Cedars Sinai by Dr. Charles Louy. He specializes in this. He is not an interventional radiologist. He is an anesthesiologist. He's the head of pain management at Cedars Sinai. So he's an extremely talented doctor. I love him. But there are some things I wanted to talk to you about. If you are watching this video and you're going in for a high volume blood patch, by Dr. Louis, if he's performing it, or maybe somebody else. There are some things I wish I would have known going in. And the first thing is, I didn't know at all going into it that it was going to be a high volume patch. I actually went in through the emergency room, and I had just come out of a wonderful period of 3 weeks of feeling absolutely wonderful. It was the best I had felt in 6 years, and I'll talk more about that in a different video. My acute phase of the CSF leak started in May of 2019. So, but I've suffered from a chronic illness since 2013, and it was just a great, great time. And I'm not exactly sure why it failed. It may have been because I lifted my son just shy of the 6 week mark of my patch. I don't know. Anyway, it got to the point my symptoms were so bad that, and I'll talk about my actual symptoms in another video. They got so bad that I was not able to care for myself. My husband was not able to care for me effectively. I have a 3-year-old, nearly three. It just wasn't working. And I was talking very closely to my medical team. We were trying to get me scheduled. Yuri, is the scheduler at Dr. Shiving's office. She was trying to find a reasonable appointment for me to have my outpatient procedure. And I just let them all know, I'm sorry, I don't think I can wait. And they did a wonderful job of notifying the staff at the hospital that I was coming in. So although I realized as I was on my way to the hospital, it was Rosh Hashanah. So whether or not that had anything to do with the fact that I had to wait 2 days for my patch, I don't know. But I did have to wait 2 days, which is fine. They're trying to fit me in. There are lots of other people that need, immediate care and all of that stuff. I was NPO basically, or without food and water, for nearly 2 full days. There were some communication issues, whether or not I was going to go in, whether or not, like, when my imaging was going to happen, when it was not. And so one thing I really would have liked to have been a little more on top of for myself is making sure that I got adequate IV fluids. And the reason why is they had a really hard time finding a second vein in my arm, and I was so dehydrated. So it was just really unfortunate. It was so painful that the not only did the one of the anesthesiologists tried to do it, couldn't do it. He was visibly shaken by it actually because it was so painful. They kept giving me fentanyl shots, and I was like, oh. And then the IV nurse came in with an ultrasound machine. He still had a difficult time. Basically, my vein was being a Twizzler. And so this is what happened. This is actually a 10-day bruise. So if you can imagine what this was like 3 days ago, holy cow, it was so bad. So it took them quite a while to get me prepped. I also didn't know going in, not only did I not know I was having a high volume patch, I didn't know that I had to be awake the whole time, which now I understand why. Putting in that high a volume of blood is riskier. You have to continuously communicate with the patient, and Dr. Louis did a wonderful job of that. It was actually, there were some great things about being out, for a period of time with the previous patches. I had been awake the whole time with my first two at my local hospital, but that was a completely, completely different ball game, right? This patch that is being performed is a very specialized procedure. Dr. Louis specializes in this. And so I get on this table, and really one of the most painful things is just the lidocaine injection. It really stings a lot. But also, the way he was injecting the blood, he had me on a table that tilted. And I mean, there were times he was asking me what I was feeling. Oh, there's whooshing in my head. Oh, very good, very good. Okay, now what are you feeling? Oh, okay, well, I'm having some pain in my lower back. And each time he would tilt the table up or down to try to get a good coating of this blood that's going into my back. So it was a very bizarre, I'm still trying to figure out how I was up like this. And I guess maybe they had me strapped, they must have had me strapped in, I guess. I don't know. But throughout this time, he's talking to me and really making sure that that I'm communicating what I'm feeling. And once I got to the point where I was having this pretty bad lower back pain, like radicular pain, just going through my sacrum into my pelvis. He did a little bit more, I think, in this thoracic region and then stopped. And so the procedure went pretty smoothly. He made sure to tell me not to take avoid narcotics for the rebound headache. He kept told me to take mineral oil, which is disgusting. It's like drinking liquefied Vaseline, if you've ever had it before. Really gross. But very effective. So really make sure your digestive system is in order before you do these procedures. Just keep that in mind. But getting into the room and my recovery, once the pain meds wore off, it was a nightmare. I'm telling you that it was just the ridiculous pain. It went all down my legs, and I was really having trouble getting, we were, the nurses were having trouble getting a hold of a doctor to prescribe me the appropriate pain medication. Eventually, once I took my assigned dose of gabapentin, the pain went down by like tenfold at least. I'm still a little confused about all of that, and I'm very confused as to why now that I know, since I'm now taking a 4 milligram tab of Medrol at home, why I couldn't have received a steroid shot like while I was writhing in pain. I have no idea. But it's over now, and being home has been a challenge. I have not really had much of a headache, which has been really great, just a couple of minor headaches. But the radicular pain, my sacrum pain, has been off the, it's been out of control. So luckily, talking to nurse practitioner Rachel, I've been, she gave me a course of steroids, and I've had that for what, 3 days I've been on this, and I'm now starting to feel a little bit more normal. And I feel like I have a good handle on my recovery, but I'm taking things much, much more gently than I have in the past. It's probably going to be, well, it will be 8 weeks before I can lift anything over 5 pounds. And definitely, I will wait 10 weeks to lift my son because I just can't risk it. If this doesn't work out, I'm going back to the drawing board and I'll have another consult with Dr. Shavink. But I really appreciate the staff at Cedars. They've been great. Most of my nurses were really, really wonderful. And of course, the assistants there were great too. But I'll give you more updates as I am recovering, and any additional stuff that comes up, I'll make sure to let you guys know. And I hope this has been helpful for those of you searching for information. I know it's hard, but yeah, I'll be putting more updates up soon. So have a great day, and I hope you're finding the answers you're looking for, and you're on the way to wellness.